Welcome back to Pokemon Let's Play Retrospective. We are back and we are going to explore that cave we didn't fully explore, which we did in the previous game, but this time the trainers may be different, so we will see. There's a Wubat. Should we care for the speed IV? Sure, why not? Also, Braviary needs to recover the friendshipness, all the friendship it lost from being knocked out from the fight against Game Freak. Game Freak is so evil, they took away some really good moves in the most recent games and they have no mercy to fan favorite features. So we will beat up this battle girl and I hope she has attack IV Pokemon, because I'm really pissed that all my Pokemon that don't need attack IVs get unnecessary attack IVs. But Medicham, like, did we talk about Medicham? I think we did talk about Medicham. Pure power boost, doubling its attack. This generation, not as effective. Elemental punches. High jump kick, which got buffed to 130 base power. With its massive, huge power, it hits really hard. Give it a scarf and it will ball break like nothing. I think it also gets bullet punch, if I'm not mistaken. Hitmonlee. Oh, we didn't talk about the Hitmons. This generation, Hitmons also got the hidden ability. So, Reckless also boost High Jump Kick. High Jump Kick has 130 base power fighting type moves. So, if you have that and Blades Kick, you have already perfect coverage. And you can finish off some annoying Pokemon with Mach Punch. So Hitmonlee, really good Pokemon. Now, add Unburden from the Dream World and use Normal Gem Fake Out to get the immediate speed boost without worrying that your opponent can stop you. So you double your speed and the next round you outspeed literally everything. You can obviously also use a Fighting Gem and try your luck with a Fighting Gem boosted High Jump Kick, but I would go for priority Mach Punch instead. If you are in certain setting, you can revenge kill something. But usually, you know, Fake Out is the preferred option. The negative is that you would rather reset the one you get from the pre-evolution. You would likely reset for what you want, because you can't break down hidden abilities of the Hitmons because they are all male, and only female Pokemon can break down the hidden ability. And we need to activate the drowsing machine here so we can find the items that are hidden. There doesn't seem to be any, so let's go down and see if we find any suitable opponents. We have plenty of returns to spare, so let's just use them. Down. And Angry Girl got another level. Let me just. And I don't think Hitmonchan got anything from the Dream World that is worth mentioning, nor did Hitmontop. If I remember, I will talk in the next video. They are useless, their other abilities. Like, Hitmontop still intimidates, but Intimidate defensive rapid spinner with, wait a second, we didn't pick up anything that can learn flash, did we? Let me check, do we even have flash? I don't think so. but we might have. We might have from that one, that guy that just throws it towards us. There it is. Let's see who can move flash. Nobody. So how are we going to explore this cave? The answer is not at all. So sorry guys, I wasted all our time for no reason. We already explored this part. So I need to think which Pokemon could we add that can learn flash. Should we try our luck with another Pachirisu? I don't think so. Cresselia, you can learn flash, can't you? Let's get rid of the most broken Pokemon in our team, because we want a small handicap. And then we teach it flash. Yes, it can learn flash. So we get rid of Future Sight, because what are we gonna do with it? And then we enter the cave again. So let's go. I think here I activate that one repel we have received, which just sticks out like a sore thumb. And then we just use Surf and... Okay. The broken Pokemon was our Surf use. Oh god. I should have checked everything. So, we wasted our Repel for no reason. And I need to... Vicurum has not a single move that we can use. So we deposit Curem and we barrel will be able to get us through the cave. So Hitmontop uses a defensive set with Intimidate to get rid of hazards. Maybe set up on the opponent with Bulk Up and maybe beat Ghost types with that move that lets you hit Ghost and Normal. Ghost types with Normal and Fighting type moves. I don't remember this name from the top of my head. Mach Punch to pick up Surprise KOs. It can use High Jump Kick, but I would not recommend that. Yet, the Rapid Spinner of choice. Sometimes it uses Toxic, but you can use the Technician set to hit, be a bit more offensive. Stone Edge, I think it can learn. Mach Punch gets boosted. Need to look up what it can and what it can't learn. Hitmontop has Iron Fist as its preferred ability and the only useful ability for it, which boosts its punching moves, but it is completely outclassed by Gerda. By a not fully evolved Pokemon. So its only niche is to Rapid Spin in any. That non-fully evolved Pokemon hits harder, has better bulk, and is a better Pokemon when it comes to setup sweeping with bulk up. And it has also Mach Punch, it has also Ice Punch, it can also learn Stone Edge, it can do a lot. Payback is a notable move it can learn, and there's Fighting type master. I hope we can beat him. Hopefully he has attack IV Pokemon itself, so this thing definitely has a fighting type move. I mean attack IV, fighting type move for sure, but if it can have, let's see, whatever. So we can finish it off, even the attack ID. But it keeps wasting our turn. So Rapid Spin, Ice Punch, Fire Punch, Earthquake, or... And close combat is what you will probably see from Hitmonchan. Conqueror, Evil Gravebird, this one. So it's a hit burst, probably the burst fighting type of that you can use in this generation. Unless you count non-full level of Pokemon, but even then it is outclassed. I think even Machoke could outclass it in some regards. So this only niche it has is Rapid Spin. So we get rid of the Splash and finally teach Angry Girl some dancing moves. Let's surf here. And pick up that item here. It's our next revive. We will probably need it later. It's up there. So I guess we can use surf and go here. There's another fighting girl, battle girl, whatever. Let's see what she has. Probably more fighting types. We surely want the attack IVs of the fighting type Pokemon, like Prime Ape. It's a good Pokemon to kill. This Primate Pokemon. I will Brave Bird the Primate. I'm not so certain if we can one shot it with Return here. Okay, next up should be Hitmonchan. Hitmonchan definitely is bulky. So we have point, goes for detect. You know, we can try our luck. I don't want to risk getting more damage. This goes for focus punch. But now we hit it with super effective fly. And the last but not least is Scrafty. I will go for fly here too. Goes for focus punch. We should dodge it. We dodge the punch and then we retaliate with fly. Or dodge. Nope. And we KO'd it. Scrafty gets scrafted. Amazing. Now we go up here and here we should be able to take this. Okay, we stand just here. Come on. Here it is, Carbos. So we found on Carbos, which gives us one speed ID, and we found the protector. With the protector we can evolve Rhyperior to a Rhydon to Rhyperior. Here's another martial artist of black belt. And what does he have? He has this annoying Pokemon and which we are going to use fly on. And two turn move, I hope it doesn't have broke up. Goes for the superpower. Well, this Pokemon is even worse than Hitmonchan. If I could say so, it can't even learn Rapid Spin. Here's Hitmontop. Hitmontop does the insane thing, intimidating our Brave Bird and gives us a plus one attack stat. Thanks, idiot. One shot it. And next is Machamp. Machamp may have no guard, so I can't risk fly, only to get Stone Edged and say, usually invisible turn. So I'm going to attack here and risk getting knocked out. Would be nice if we could heal somewhere, but should I? I think Brave Bird deserves a break here, and I think I will still activate the Drowsy Machine. Maybe I should go like this and see if we find another item. Doesn't seem like what's inside here. With a drill board? Yeah, it's extra drill. We can one shot it with Earthquake. And get some attack at least out of this thing. For our angry girl. Neat. So if we go like this, I will take care of what's below later. Would the barrel be so kind? Oh no. This is a veteran. And veteran are really, really powerful trainers. So let's see what he has. So far, many of the veterans were really hard to defeat. This one has 6 Pokemon. I bet he bet has nothing. Is that? Oh god, it's Gyarados. And we didn't have him, her in the front. And him. Let's try our luck. Let's go for Rock Slide and hopefully flinch it. Goes for the super effective waterfall. Can we take this waterfall? It crit. Great. Okay. Brave Bird. It's your turn. Let's go for Brave return here. And I should take it out. Which we did. I think it's the next. Next we are going to heal. Gigalith. I don't think we can defeat this one. Max revive. Let's max revive here and it went for the Stone Edge. We had already so little health and I don't get it. Well, let Extrachad handle this. We go for one Earthquake. I think Sandy will boost if we survive the next turn. And then I will retaliate with Amazurf. But this is not good. I will go for another Earthquake. Predicting he would go for something else. Dridicon. Does it have any coverage moves that could kill me? It could have Earthquake. Let's go for Earthquake ourselves. Wasn't enough. Goes for Flamethrower. Yeah, it was enough to take us down. I will switch to Cresselia and once more go for another max revive. I can't believe these generic trainers are strong enough to force me to use max revive. Okay, let's go for extra chip once more. Goes for Night Slash. Let's flash here. I will be using this thing as a death fodder. not only is that, but it will also be my setup for them. So we will cheese our way out of this, which I normally don't like, but how does it keep hitting? But it's not bad, and we can just heal ourselves after that. This seems like it's working. Sorry for this display of pitiful gameplay. Cresslia, you have done well. Evil. From here, Extrachad will end this. So let's go for as strong as we can. Goes for a flamethrower. Don't burn. Okay. Second sword dance. We are now plus four, and this is plus six. Okay, from this range we can one hit KO everything. Should be enough to sweep the entire team. So next up is Excadrill of his own. That's not a problem, we one shot Excadrill. Let's see. Yes. Next up is... we don't want Hyper Beam, let's get rid of it. Next Pokemon is Snorlax. Look at this beefy Pokemon here. It's almost comical. So we are plus 6. We should be able to one-shot the Snorlax. I can't believe that I even say that. Crobat. This is troublesome. But we'll do Air Slash. Don't flinch. And we one-shot it with strength, right? We don't need to rely on Rock Slide here, and with this we have defeated the mighty veteran, Sean. Why such a powerful tree? There's a maximum life, and our reward is Focus Blast, which we can teach Kyurem and someone else, but we will talk about that later. Let's first revive Brave Bird here. And switching back to the front. Oh yeah, and the Drowsing Machine. Don't forget the Drowsing Machine. Let's get back to the water. Then we go here, that's nothing. Back to the water. Let's use another repel. Is there anything else? We defeated him, we defeated her. And now we find this low sweep. Like this. Okay, we went like this and we defeated all the trainers that are here. And there's another ice team I sort. We don't need anything anymore. We can encounter this Pokemon, whatever it is. It is a builder. Let's see what other Pokemon are here besides Swoopant. I think we wasted the next revive for Mossa. But at least now I know that. We are done with exploring this cave. I don't even know what the cave is. and we might switch some of our members. You have done well, Bilberry. Didn't get a chance to unleash your immense power. But we can now check and see if Pachirizo is actually here to visit us. Oh, it's a Pachirizo. Yeah, it's... you can catch Pachirizo here. Should we catch it? Let Bravebird decide. Are you worthy to be caught? And it seems like it's not. So it's dead. Yeah, I think we are pretty much done for today's recording session. Let's check for a Nidoran spawned. And then we end today's recording session for now. So, will a Nidoran spawn? Let's go on the bike. Make this, and here is the grotto where you can catch a Nidoran. And instead we find a virtual Ioceros with analytic. And he's really mad that we came here. And you know what? I don't like Watchhawk. So we will crush its dreams. Back to the dream world. Back to the dream world. Destroyed. But Angry Girl seems to be satisfied with the IVs it's getting from killing this thing. Next time we try finding something more interesting. See you around and goodbye.